Today, we're going to set up an oversimplified Django website so you can get a quick overview of Django and so that anybody claiming that Flask is faster and easier to set up can see how simple Django can really be. Django is a batteries included framework as opposed to a lightweight framework like Flask, but that doesn't mean that setting up a website with a full-fledged framework like Django can't be just as easy. In this video, we'll go for speed instead of using best practices, so without worrying about the best way to set things up, let's create our first Django project. Before we install Django, let's first make sure we have Python installed. If you already have that completed, then go ahead and run pip install Django from your command prompt. Next, create a Django application by running django-admin start project and call your website my website. This command will create the boilerplate files for you, so go ahead and use the text editor of your choice and open up your project files. In the urls.py file, we have a list of URL patterns to map our URLs to views. Views are just functions or classes that return back some sort of HTTP response. Because we are focusing on speed and not best practices, let's create our views right inside of the URLs file. Let's create a view called index and make sure to pass in the request object as a parameter. And for the return method, let's import the JSON response function and use it in the return value for our view. In the JSON response, let's set the value of safe to false. Now all you have to do is use the path function, which takes in a URL parameter we want to set for this route and the view that we want to trigger, and that's it. Now open up your command prompt and make sure you're CD'd into your project, then run python manage.py run server. You can open up this website by copying the port number specified in the terminal and pasting this into your browser. If you see this JSON response, you did everything correctly and have successfully set up an oversimplified Django website. Now, if you want to return some HTML templates, create a folder called templates in the root directory of your project. Now, in the settings.py file, the templates value tells Django where to look for our templates. We'll go ahead and point this to the new templates folder that we just created. Now, go back to your URLs file, and instead of returning the JSON response, import the render method, and return the render method while passing in the request object and the HTML template that we want to use. In this case, let's go ahead and create a file called index.html inside of that templates folder. Now, if you open up your website again and refresh the page, you should see this template instead of the JSON response. Now, if we wanted to follow best practices, we would create our views inside of their own file and simply import them into the urls.py file anytime we wanted to use those specific views. The area where people seem to think Django takes longer to set up over something like Flask is in the process of setting up something called apps. Apps just allow us to break up our code even more, so we're not writing a bunch of code in one file or folder. They do take a minute to set up sometimes and can confuse absolute beginners in the first experiences with Django, but once you get past this small learning curve, you won't think twice about this in the future. If you want to learn how to set up a Django application the right way and follow best practices, check out my courses on Udemy and my free projects on my YouTube channel.